Hey everyone, it's Wingspan TT, and if you're watching, you know what time it is. It's time for Duels 2013. It's me against Starsweet once again. He wanted a rematch, and I'm like, alright, I'll give you a rematch. In the face. And I decided I'm going to switch over to Celestial Light because, I don't know, everyone saw me playing Celestial Light in the WMG tournament, and they're like, well, you know, that was a really good matchup against Born of Flame, so how would it do against other decks? Well, now you know. Now you know, and knowing's half the battle. He's playing Peacekeepers. So now you're going to get to see how Celestial Light does against Peacekeepers. Now my build that I have here is not the same build that I used against, that I used in the finals against Frizzy. So it's going to be a little bit different. You're going to see some different cards because I'm not specced against red. But I feel pretty good going in here. He can't swing with 2-1 when I got my Soul Warden on the board. I got my Sarah Ascendant on the board. Oh, going up to 22 life. And I did post my deck build online, although, I wonder if I should just swing. If he loses 2-1 this early. I don't know, but then I'm going to do 1 damage to him and lose my guy. I'm just going to leave him back to block. I am willing to throw away a Soul Warden to kill 2-1. Ultimately, the Soul Warden, you know, or I could kill my... Does he not have the extra land, or is he just toying with me? I wonder if he's what he's willing to do here. He's probably going to play another creature. But if I could set him back with that much aggro, it's probably worth it. Let's see. If he plays another creature, then I lose out on 1 life. But if I block here, then I lose out on the... I'm just going to do this. Losing out 1 life, not a big deal. And I'm pretty sure he doesn't have a creature pump spell for 1 mana. He plays the land, and here comes the creature. Let's see it. Play it. I know you have it. Is it Quarter Paladin? No, it's Spectral Rider. All right. Not a big deal. I'm up at 22. I'm feeling pretty good, and here we go. Now, Recumbent Bliss, normally, in a lot of other decks, right, you would say you want to leave your removal for the most important creature. But in this case, because you gain 1 life a turn, I want to play as early as possible. That way I can gain as much life as possible with that card. So now I can attack now. This thing has lifelink, everyone forgets that. So I can go up to 23 life, then my next upkeep, I go up to 24 life. I'm going to be in a pretty good position to start gaining life early in the game. Also, if I drop a Pride Mate early, gain some more life. This thing's got Intimidate, it's not that scary. Here you go, Doom Traveler. That is a little more scary. And a Quarter Paladin. Great. Great. At least it's a 3-1, so my Ascendant can take it out. Now here I have a tough call. Oh, wow. Alright. See, if I play this turn, I can't do anything. That's it, I can't even equip it. No point. So I'm not going to play that. If I play Seraph of Dawn, 4 mana, okay? Then next turn, if I draw another land, I have 5 mana. Oh, this is 6 to equip. Never mind. That doesn't make any sense either. Might as well drop the Seraph of Dawn, get some board presence. If I attack with 1-1, he's just going to block there and gain his flyer. So if I get this on the board, he can't attack with this guy. He probably can't attack with that guy. He'll be forced to remove it, although he probably has removal. But whatever. Use my removal on 2-4 guys so you don't have it when I get my Baneslayers out. Because that's how I roll. I just roll Baneslayers all day long. Starsweet, here we go. Let's see, Starsweet, what do you got? What do you got? Come on, let's hit it. Hit it with the door to Journey to Nowhere. The door to nothingness. Nope. Alright, Crusader of Odric. It's going to be 4-4. I don't think he's going to attack into this. I could be wrong. I really don't think he's going to attack. Nope. And here we go. I got a Pride Mate. Very cool. I could drop the Pride Mate. I can swing with the Angel, it'll automatically go to 3-3. I would love to get this Well Lost Dreams. See, this is the thing that sucks. It's just like so much mana to use all this stuff. But I think it's more important to get the Pride Maiden to play, get up to be a 3-3 as soon as possible to hold off his attackers. I don't know. If I play the Well of Lost Dreams, then I get to draw an extra card for the rest of the game as long as this thing's in play. But it's going to eat up a lot of mana. Could also drop the Warhammer into play, but it's a whole turn before anything even happens. I feel like I should get the Pride Mate in play. Attack with this guy, go up to 27. Pride Mate goes up to 3-3. Can block the Doom Traveler, no problem. If he swings with everything, I'll probably just eat it. Or I might throw... I don't know if I should throw away my Sarah's Ascendant. I don't know, we'll see. We'll see what happens. I'll see what he actually does. I would take 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 damage. I go down to 17. How terrible. It's never a bad idea when you're down 17. I might feel like I'm gonna throw away my pride mate though on the quarter paladin. Otherwise, I'm gonna be taking extra damage every turn. Or I could block this thing. No, I might as well block the Doom Traveler, prevent the damage now, because then it'll be a 4-4 next turn. Oh, that is dirty. That is goddamn dirty. Wow. All right, I'm down to 15 life. Really bad board position. Real bad. Except I just drew the exact same thing. Something tells me he doesn't have another one of those. So I'm totally cool with doing the exact same thing this turn. And what I like is I'm able to stay on the offensive here, and now that I have absolutely no chance of like probably hitting the 30 life, I'm totally okay with using the Sarah's Ascendant to block the quarter paladin if he even attacks with it again. If he does, then this guy's going to go up to 4-4 and then a 5-5 on my upkeep, rolling it up. I don't like how there's no draw step. You know, I know in regular Magic you are allowed to cast things during the upkeep, and in this game... Ah, what the hell? He just wants to fuck up all my math today. He just wants to do it all day long. Alright, he's just going to attack the 2-2, the 5-5, the 4-2. I feel like I should just chump. I'm just going to chump here, not take the 6. This thing's gonna go up to 4-4 again? What is this? Alright, whatever. Fine. It's bigger, but it doesn't have trample, right? This thing doesn't have trample. Alright, just checking. Alright, now this goes up to 4-4, and then in my upkeep it's gonna go up to 5-5. I guess I could leave this thing back to block now. Damn. I could play the Well of Lost Dreams. Yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna do. He's got the 5-5. God damn, this sucks. Well, he's not... Oh, man, this sucks. This absolutely sucks. I guess I could play the Well of Lost Dreams. Hope I draw a land next turn. When he attacks, he only has one card in hand, so hopefully it's nothing too critical. I can block his 2-2 here. Gain life. 5-5. I could throw in the quarter this paladin if I have to. And pay an extra land to draw a card. Alright, this thing's just getting absolutely gigantic. It's just fucking scary now. It's an 8-8, 9-9, 10-10. I need a day of judgment. I need a day of judgment. Because my judgment is now coming. It's very soon. Alright, this guy I can definitely block. I can take the 9 damage on the chin. He's going to swing with the smaller guys. Let's see what he does. People always complain that you don't have enough time to choose your blockers. He's really considering like, what should you do here. But one thing you do is you could just always pause like here and just think about it before your actual blocking comes up. Alright, my 5-5, I'm going to throw in his 4-2 so I don't take the extra damage every turn. I'm going to take, I guess, oh, shit, how much damage am I going to take? That's a lot. That's lethal damage, isn't it? Fuck. I didn't think this through. Did not think this through. That is lethal damage. If I block here, that's 4. What can I not block? Why can't I block this guy? What? Is it lag? Please tell me it's lag. Please tell me it's lag. Please tell me it's lag. Okay, shit. Okay, good. It's lag. Alright. Block this guy here. If I leave this through, I lose the game. That's it. So I have to throw away my angel. No. Shit! No! God damn it! The timer went that fast? Alright. That's it. I lost the game. Timer. Thanks. Alright. I'm done here.